list those key stakeholders she is engaged with to facilitate change since her appointment, as outlined in the revised cabinet portfolios for 2017-18. I appreciate it being a long list, maybe a short list, but I'd like to know the list. Thank you. Thank you, Madam Mayor. Thank you, Madam Mayor. I have one question for the cabinet member for the environment. We read on page 22 of the annual report that recycling rates continue to decline. The average recycling rate in Wirral is now barely half of the best performing authorities. Does he still support the Wirral plan target to achieve a 50% rate by 2020? And do his plans include a food waste recycling service?
Thank you. Okay, thank you for those questions. And now I'm going to start with Sir George Davis.
Thanks, Madam Mayor. And just to reply to Ian, homelessness and £40 million bid. Yes, I know we did put in the bid and we were not successful. However, I'd just like to point out, and it's in the acting report as well, that the homelessness and housing options team has been intervening to prevent 1,291 households from becoming homeless during 16-17 by working with other relevant local agencies, leading to the early identification of households and individuals who are likely to be vulnerable to homelessness. And that has worked within budgets. So I accept the point that you put in your bid. We weren't successful, I should have said that we did that anyway. Thank you.
Thank you, Madam Mayor. Councillor Clements, yes, we'd be absolutely delighted to be involved with them. We'd like to help Gloucester when the big group of things can be. I think we've tried to simplify it in this council, but obviously we'd be glad to help the end vote or without consultation. Councillor Leakey, I did send you an email on Saturday morning. Well, I did send it and I didn't have one in back to say that it hadn't been delivered, but I will double check.
You missed a second
that
you haven't been
maybe. Can I say that every effort is being made, Madam Mayor, to keep residents safe in the new Tollemash premises? As Councillor Blakey knows, it was human error actually on Friday night that someone hadn't blocked the electric gate. Which was needed, so that, but no one was hurt. But can I just say that for the members of the council did come and look at Tollemash Road, and they were very big on the 2 days that we set aside and invited all the members of the council. After we've been talking about it so long, it was rather disappointing that so few people came. But they would know that Tollemash Road, the accommodation, everybody has a single room with ensuite facilities. The deck hall and the artwork have been chosen by the service users, so they can even pick which room they want. There's a variety of different colours, different artwork. So what we provided is not just equal to, it is much better than the previous accommodation that people forced to go to for their respite. And I've been absolutely assured by the manager that they are doing absolutely everything to keep people safe. Staff are being retrained. And the system that's in place is within CQC best practice, bearing in mind legislation around deprivation of liberty. So things are a little bit more complicated than perhaps people might think. Thank you, Madam Mayor.
Thanks, Councillor Kelly, for your question. I will obviously be sending you a written response to give you a more detailed response. Although the Women's and Art Gallery isn't mentioned directly in the annual report, our commitment to arts and culture is threaded throughout the report, and we are working very closely with everybody at the Williamson and with friends groups to make sure that their views are totally taken on board begin our, the next phase of our agenda.
This is going to be subject to the polling. I think that it's appropriate. sure that the update I give you is absolutely spot up to date to what's happened at this present moment in time. I always said that I'd never sort of say I'll give a written answer because I don't like giving written answers. But this is so serious and it needs to be right. I don't want to give any misinformation to anybody. So this question will be answered. I'm sorry for it, but this question will be answered in a written form when I get an absolute up-to-date report from the officers who are looking after this. I hope that's okay for you, but that's my response at the moment.
Thank you. Councillor Bradley.
Thank you, Madam Mayor. Thank you for the question, Councillor Cleary. Yes, I absolutely support it. Indeed, I hope it's passive in the rules of time. I note too that both Scotland and Wales have now passed that 50% goal into law. I anticipate that we will follow at some point in the near future. Regarding the free waste collection fund, they're currently on hold, pending a regional review that should be published in the next few weeks. We'll get to all I say about that, but if you do want to chat about this further, I'm more than happy to meet that request.
Thank you, colleagues. That concludes meetings, executive members, and the chair's report, item 6. Now, I did indicate that we had an amendment to this Rural Plan 2020 very much report. Notice has been given of one amendment in respect of the Rural Plan annual report. It is set out on page 1 of the agenda supplement. Can I have a mover, leader, to move?
changes to the way the
stacking system, the phone system, the fact that you're on hold, and all those other menu options for the service have been changed during the year. But it says in the report, making sure residents can access services easily and quickly is vital. Well, no one's going to disagree with that. And it does go on to say it's incredibly frustrating for residents to not to have easy access. Well, perhaps the report should apologise for some of the past failures. Then I'll turn to page 43. Now, this is really Councillor Whittingham's favourite area of activity. I used to do the public realm by street lighting, and members of the council have drawn attention to the backlog and questioned just how much progress is being made. The report says we will redouble our efforts. Well, again, how do we measure whether the council has redoubled its efforts? Perhaps it's like one of those ducks on a pond. A friend of mine showed me a picture of ducks on a pothole. They were plastic ducks on a pothole in some of the council in the middle of the country. And like the ducks on the pond, perhaps the colleagues are paddling like mad underwater, but we can't always see it. So perhaps the annual report might be more specific. But Councillor Whittingham is smiling, of course, and he knows just how much we pursue the light in the potholes. And then finally, I want to know on page 44 what is an adult conversation? Perhaps we can have an explanation of we must be ready to have adult conversations and difficult debates like the traditional council services. So I do